Hello everyone, my name is David Gray Witter, he, him, and today I'm presenting our paper, Trust in Collaborative Automation in High-Stakes Software Engineering Work, a case study at NASA, conducted with colleagues at Jet Propulsion Laboratory and Carnegie Mellon University. Picture this, your team at NASA is developing the control software for a soon-to-launch high-profile space mission. NASA has a history of successful multi-million dollar space missions. The software your team creates can't be the reason this mission fails. Instead of writing code manually, your team is using a new automated tool to help build this software. The tool generates low-level control code from input you can provide either graphically, with a high-level markup language, or an architectural modeling language. We know from literature that tool trust affects software engineering outcomes, but we don't know what factors affect trust in software engineering tools. How do you evaluate whether you trust the new automated tool you're using to build this software for this high-stakes mission? In a 10-week ethnography, including 21 interviews with expert and novice tool users, 8 user studies with a new interaction method for the tool, and many hours of participant observation, we study how trust develops in an automated software engineering tool in a high-stakes workplace context. In our context, we find that trust is best framed as a quality the operator places in their ability to work with the automated tool to achieve open-ended goals together, as opposed to the more traditional framing we saw in past literature, where trust is placed in the system to achieve a specific goal. This fits our context. Space mission software can take a decade to develop, launch, and maintain, and is sometimes repaired using the same software tools it was built with, meaning that knowing exactly what you want to create with the software in advance is often impossible. This framing also comes from our data. Next, I'll illustrate our collaborative trust framing with a few of the 16 contextually dependent trust factors we identify and describe in the paper. First, we found that past personal experience using the tool gave people confidence that they could trust using it for the work they're doing today, noting that past experience allows them to know what it can do, as shown by the quote here. This was often the first justification given when participants were asked why they said they trusted the tool. Similarly, participants trusted the tool more when colleagues had successfully worked with it to complete similar tasks, one participant describing this as heritage when asked if he trusts the tool, as shown by the quote here. Another participant said that the past mission use lent heritage for certain parts of the system, leading them to trust these parts more. When the operator made a mistake and the automated tool did not catch the error, participants lost trust in the tool because they expected their tool collaborator to catch the error. More worryingly, errors were occasionally introduced in a way that would propagate from the original human operator through the tool to a third human teammate, risking both the reputation of the tool, but also the human operator, as shown in the quote, "I mistyped the word and it just jammed it into output with no errors. It should check. The error will pop up in code you didn't write." From this, we noticed that human operators expected the automated tool to not introduce errors without warning, but also to fill in or make up for the human operator's errors. Bugs in the automated tool reduced the human operator's trust that they could use it to achieve their goals. However, and importantly, when the human operator felt they had a good understanding of where the tool's bugs or deficiencies were, this increased their trust that they could work around them and work with the tool, as shown by the quote here. We see that knowing where the deficiencies are not only didn't hurt, but actually increased this participant's trust in the tool. Finally, some participants expressed that they only felt able to trust the tool after inspecting how it works, to be able to know that the tool would generate code of the same form in response to their input that they would expect to write manually. One participant trusted a new feature of the tool only after inspecting the resulting auto-generated code, illustrated by this quote. Participants did this to check whether they understand how the tool works as shown here, but also to check that the resulting code can be understood by themselves and others who may have to interact with it. To conclude, our study contributes to an increased understanding of human automation trust in context. We outline the framing of collaborative trust, trust the operator places in their ability to work with the automated tool to achieve open-ended goals together. This framing can be used to study trust in autonomous systems as they are increasingly able to collaborate in creative work contexts. To support this framing, we identify and describe 16 factors affecting automated tool trust in high-reliability software engineering contexts. In the paper, we outline implications for software engineering organizations and for tool designers to support appropriate tool trust.
Thank you. I hope you enjoy reading the paper. Please feel free to email or tweet at me with questions.